The once tranquil holiday haven under siege again. The sky turning an eerie blood orange, then almost pitch black at 2:30 in the afternoon.
Very eerie and it's incredible, isn't it?
Moments earlier, ash showered down as nervous residents went into battle.
Just watering down all the areas that can catch fire with the embers.
Any hot ones come down, I'll get the carpet on fire and fuel will go up.
As authorities warn the town to brace itself for another day of extreme danger, scores of young families with babies remain trapped.
Lou's just come down with smoke-induced laryngitis, so he's sort of pretty croaky and pretty miserable today.
While some chose to stay behind, the elderly and children under five weren't allowed on the ship, plans for their air evacuation grounded, with military planes unable to fly due to the smoke.
Literally stuck until an aircraft can actually reach Melakuta and take us out.
With the sky looking as apocalyptic as this, it's easy to see why aircraft simply can't come into town, potentially leaving many stranded here indefinitely. 80-year-old Lindsay has been waiting days to escape.
It's a bugger of a joint to get in and out of. You can't get out.
While this man who suffered three heart attacks has no way out.
I wasn't allowed to go on the boat, according to the medical staff up here. I had to be flying out.
Amid all of the devastation, tales of inspiration.
They've just banded together. It's just beautiful.
Patrick Boyle risked his own life to save precious animals.
Going pretty bad.
With the wildlife centre evacuated, volunteers moved injured animals into a hall, koalas, birds, even a joey.
I'm just frightened what's out there still. I don't want to do this.
Doing a good job.
There's going to be so many more, and the people that are arranging for stuff to come in is just, what I've been told, is phenomenal.
Joining us live from Melakuta is Sam Kuchiara. Sam, what are conditions like right now?
But it's very smoky at the moment, and as you can see, it still looks like we're in the middle of the night. As we go to air, thousands of people remain cut off here in Melakuta. I've just been into the community meeting, and we've heard the fire threat for this town has now passed, for now at least. Tonight, those two Navy vessels will be making their way back from Melbourne here to Melakuta, and we've also just learned that one of those ships will also start taking children under five, as long as their parents can make some strict conditions, like ensuring they haven't enough food and supplies to last that 20-hour voyage. Still, some families I've spoken to tonight say it's going to be a very long and nervous night ahead.